Dear students, in previous lecture we have discussed about the rediscovery of Mendel's work and its importance. In today's lecture we will discuss about the Mendel's experimental technique. As we know that Mendel were called as the father of genetics because he gave the clear-cut principle which formed the basis of modern genetics. That's why he is called father of genetics. Then one question arises, what is the procedure which Mendel follow which make him succeed? Because in previous lecture we have talked about the advantages of selecting pea plant by Mendel. Then what is the procedure which Mendel follow to get succeed? Today we will discuss about Mendel's experimental technique. What is the technique which Mendel used to cross-pollinate or self-pollinate the pea plant? Mendel performed his experiment basically in three steps. Mendel conducted his breeding experiment in three steps. Mendel conducted his breeding experiment in three steps. These three steps are, number one, first of all, he select pure plant, selection of pure plant. Second one is hybridization of pure plant. And the last one is self-pollination in hybrids. As Mendel performed his experiment in three steps, number one, selection of pure plant, means Mendel showed the plants in his garden and collected the seed, again showed them, and he select out of them only the pure plant. In second step, he involves hybridization of pure plant. What is hybridization? It is the intermixing or mixing of two different characters of a plant or two different varieties of a plant. And the third one is self-pollination in hybrids. Thus, hybrids formed in the second step were self-pollinate. What is self-pollination? Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma within the same plant. That is called as self-pollination. If transfer of pollen grains takes place from anther to stigma in different plant, that is called cross-pollination. But he used self-pollination. Now we will discuss three points in detail. First point is selection of pure plant. As the name suggests, pure plant. Mendel raised seeds by self-pollination, having different traits. What are traits? I have told you these are also called as characters. Different traits, and showed them in garden. You can also check these experiments by doing yourself. You can also follow these steps and you will get that the results told by Mendel are exactly same. The first step he done, Mendel raised seeds by self-pollination having different traits and again showed them in garden. Plants that grow from these seeds showed showed each of seven traits. As in previous lecture I have told you seven traits selected by Mendel. He showed plants and seen that each of seven traits were expressed independently. Now he followed the second step. What was the second step? Means hybridization of pure plant. As in the first step, 7 traits were raised independently. Thus, seeds he showed, they show their character independently. Now he done the hybridization of a pure plant. What is hybridization? The process of crossing or mating of two varieties of plants or animals is known as a hybridization. Means when two different variety plants are mixed, that is, are crossed, that is called as a hybridization. What does Mendel did? Mendel crossed pure plants having contrasting traits. What are contrasting traits? I have told you, as I take an example of height, then there are two contrasting traits. One is tall, one is a dwarf. Then Mendel crossed pure plants having contrasting traits. As we can say, one tall and one dwarf. After that, seeds formed by crossing of plants, were collected and again plants were raised and produce hybrid seed. In first step, he crossed the contrasting trait. After crossing, the seeds were produced. He again collect those seeds and again plants were raised. These plants produce hybrid seeds. In this way, the first generation which is obtained, first generation of Mendel, Mendel's crossing was named as first filial generation, indicated by symbol F1. What is the symbol used for the first filial generation? That is a F1. Who used this symbol? By Batson and Saunders in 1902. For first filial generation, the term symbol used was a F1, which was given by Batson and Saunders in 1902. Now our last step comes, that is third. Now the hybrids formed were self-pollinated. Self-pollination in a hybrids. In third steps, he self-pollinate the hybrids. Means the F1 plants which were produced in the second step were self-pollinated. We can write plants produced in F1 generation were self-pollinated. The seeds produced were collected and showed them and showed them which produce second filial generation or called as F2, and if further showed them and self pollinate in F2 give F3 means third filial generation and so on. So in this way we can self pollinate hybrids and results are obtained. So these are the three techniques used by Mendel. Now question arises, sir, you told that these were the three steps, but these are written in words. Tell me or tell us by diagrammatic representation. For this, I take an example in which we will use the single trait for inheritance and will show its crossover. We can say this as a inheritance of one gene. Now we will follow the procedure which was used by Mendel, in which he crossed over the single gene or single character. Inheritance of one gene scientifically called as a monohybrid cross. We can also use dihybrid cross, but in dihybrid, di means two, in which we will write inheritance of two genes. Inheritance of two genes will called as dihybrid cross. Inheritance of one gene called as a monohybrid cross. So then we can write its definition: a breeding experiment, a breeding experiment dealing with a single character, dealing with a single character is known as monohybrid cross. We'll call it as a monohybrid cross. Or we can write down another definition: inheritance of a single character, inheritance of a single character is called as a monohybrid cross. Mendel performed monohybrid cross in case of size of stem. He crossed on basis of height, that is size of a stem. He selected pure tall and pure dwarf. As we know, tall was denoted by capital T, dwarf was denoted by small t. If we cross over this capital T small t, this is the F1 generation. In F1 generation, one capital T, one small t. The list which we show the seven traits selected by Mendel, I have write down dominant and recessive trait, where tall was dominant and small t, capital T was dominant and small t was recessive. So in all cases there is presence of capital T, which means in F1 generation all plants grown were tall. In third steps we have discussed self pollination of hybrids. These are hybrids, all talls that are hybrids. These are pure tall, or we can say homozygous dominant. या होमोजाइगस टाल, होमोजाइगस डवार्फ, बट दीज आर हाइब्रिड्स, वन कैपिटल टी वन स्मॉल टी. नाउ वी फर्दर सेल्फ पोलिनेट देम, वी विल सी कैपिटल टी, कैपिटल टी, कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी. After that, small t with capital T, small t, small t, small t. Always the dominant character is written first. Here capital T dominant, capital T, capital T. Here both are small t. This is tall, also tall, also tall, but it is a dwarf. Out of these, it carries both capital T. Means if I show their phenotypic ratio, phenotypic ratio, what is phenotypic ratio? External appearance of the plant. Then we will show that in F2 generation, it was F2, it is F3. In F2 generation, three plants are tall and one is a dwarf. What is their genotypic ratio? What is their genotypic ratio? What is the genotypic ratio? Genetic makeup of an individual. In it is pure tall. Pure tall. There is no other pure tall which carries both capital T, one. These both are all hybrid, capital T, small t. Hybrid tall, two, and one is a pure dwarf. Pure dwarf, one. This is the genotypic ratio in F2 generation. Then there are two definition arises, phenotype, genotype. Phenotype and genotype. What is phenotype? Phenotype doesn't see it is tall which is made up of both pure or hybrid. It only means its external appearance. Then what is phenotype? It is the external appearance. It is the external appearance of an individual is called a phenotype. What is genotype? Here I write genotype. What is genotype? Genotype is the genetic makeup of an individual. Whether it is pure or it is hybrid, it is the genetic makeup of an individual is called its a genotype. Hence, in F1 generation, all plants were tall, but in second generation or F2 generation, phenotypic ratio changes and genotypic ratio changes. Hence, from this result or from this cross, we can write down results of monohybrid cross. What are the results of a monohybrid cross? Results of monohybrid cross. Number one, as there were two traits, one tall and one dwarf, but the character appears as either tall or either dwarf. Means out of two contrasting traits, only one character will express itself. Number one will be only one character is dominant out of two contrasting traits. Second generation. As in F1 generation, all plants were tall, but in F2 generation, three plants were tall and one was dwarf. It means in F2 generation, both contrasting traits appear. Both contrasting traits appears in F2 insulation. Okay. Third, the contrasting trait, the contrasting traits of a character expressed in F2 generation or F2 plant appear in 3/4 of F2 generation. Means in F2 generation, tall was appear in F1. All plants were tall. But in F2, tall were only 3 and 1 was dwarf. Means it is 3/4. The contrasting traits of a character expressed in F2 generation appear in 3/4 of a F2 generation. And the last one is, out of 2, one of 2 contrasting traits of a character remain unexpressed, remains unexpressed in F1 generation, as dwarf was not appear in a F1 generation. Hence, out of 2 contrasting traits, 1 remain unexpressed in a F1 generation. This is the result of monohybrid cross. Then what is the conclusion which we draw from monohybrid cross? We will note down a conclusion. Number 1, gametes bring from the parents something which is appear in next generation called factor. As we have discussed already, this factor was the physical basis formed by the mender. So if you have watched my previous lecture, then you very well know what is factor. And the second conclusion which we will draw, there are a pair of unit factor for each character inherited from each parent. Means there are a pair of unit factor, means characters comes always in pairs. That is, if we talk about tall, it may be either both capital T, one capital or one small t. If we talk about dwarf, then there are both small t. Means they are present in a pairs. So in today's lecture, we will discuss only this. This is very important part of our lecture. In next lecture, we will discuss our next topic. Thank you.